Welcome to Ignite Studio's tutorial for creating vinyl t-shirt designs with the Cricut Maker. If you're new to the Cricut, make sure you check out our beginner videos, Intro to Cricut Design Space, and Using the Cricut Machine before tackling this project. I'll show you how to adhere your vinyl design to a t-shirt using iron-on vinyl and the heat press that we have here in the Ignite Studio. You can adhere iron-on vinyl to most fabrics, including tote bags, kitchen towels, pillow covers, and even shoes. In this tutorial, my sample project is to make a t-shirt with Coach spelled out on the back. I've used the classic T template to help choose the size of my text, which ends up being 11.5 by about 2.3. And I've chosen the font. I'm going to click the Make It button. And it looks like my text just fits the 12-inch by 12-inch mat. But if it was longer than 12 inches, I would have used the 12-inch by 24-inch mat we have available in Ignite, and the Cricut would have cut it out vertically. Now here's the really important part. When you use iron-on vinyl, you must mirror your image. The Cricut will cut on the back side of the vinyl, so any text or images must be cut backwards. Once you've connected your device with the Maker, make sure you choose iron-on vinyl, not vinyl, for your material. The Maker will give you a reminder to mirror your image. Now it's time to send your project to the machine for cutting. You're going to adhere your iron-on vinyl to the mat. I'm going to use the standard green mat. The iron-on vinyl has a shiny side and a dull side. The shiny side is the top carrier sheet, and the dull side is the back of the vinyl. Adhere the sheet to the mat shiny side down. It should line up in the top left-hand corner of the mat. Smooth it out well to eliminate any bubbles. Load the mat into the Cricut when the arrow button starts blinking. Remember to make sure the mat is under the two white plastic guides on either side of the machine, and start your project by pushing the button with the C when it starts blinking. Unload your mat and take the vinyl off. Lay your vinyl dull side up. This is the side you'll peel away the vinyl around your design. This is called weeding. You can use the weeding tools in the Cricut kit. Cutting close to your design makes weeding much easier and saves your vinyl for another use. The weeding tool with the hook that looks a bit like a dental tool works really well to puncture the vinyl to get it to start peeling off. I've sped up this video a bit, but you'll notice the plastic carrier sheet is very sticky, so peel slowly and carefully to make sure you don't take off your design, just the vinyl around your design. Make sure to grab any bits that remain. Now you're ready to use the heat press and to adhere the vinyl to your shirt. Ask a staff member for access to the heat press in the Fab Lab. There is a sign in the Fab Lab that is hanging next to the heat press. This is from a company called Caesar, where we purchase our iron-on vinyl that we sell here in Ignite. The sign is a list of suggested temperatures and times for pressing. We use Caesar EasyWeed, and its suggested temperature is 305, and time for pressing is between 10 and 15 seconds. You can experiment with temperatures and time length based on the fabric you are using. Push the red button on the right side to turn the press on. Use the digital display on the left to set the temperature and time. Push the set button once. The P1 setting is the temperature, which I'm keeping at 310. The P2 setting is the time setting. I'm going to use the down arrow to decrease it to 10 seconds. Press set again, and the P3 setting is for Fahrenheit. P4 and P5 aren't needed and should be on zero. Now the display will go back to the temperatures. Once the actual temperature, shown on top, reaches the desired temperature on the bottom, you are ready to press. First, you need to press your shirt for about 5 seconds to warm up the fabric. Lift the arm of the press and very carefully place the shirt on the press. The upper and lower parts of the press are over 300 degrees, so please be careful not to touch them. Then place your vinyl on the shirt where you want it, with the plastic side on top and the sticky side down on the fabric. You should be able to read the design correctly. Place a piece of parchment paper on top of the plastic and lower the arm of the heat press. Make sure you press on the arm firmly. When the time is up, the press will beep. Lift the arm, carefully remove your shirt. The Caesar vinyl is hot or cold peel, meaning you can take the plastic off right away or wait. It should come off cleanly without any pulling on the vinyl. If it pulls, press it for a few more seconds. That's it. Now the hard part. Don't handle, wear, wash, iron, or try it out for a full 24 hours to let the fabric settle. Please lower the arm of the press and turn it off. We hope we've inspired you to make your own personalized items in Ignite Studio. Our staff is always here to answer questions and give advice. Hope to see you soon.